गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू माइट बी फाइन इन योर होम. सो टुडे इन मैथ्स क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस वर्ड प्रॉब्लम ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 25. सम वर्ड प्रॉब्लम वी हैव डन बिफोर, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू प्रोसीड फर्दर. सो टुडे वी विल डू 9, 10, 12, 15, 16 and 18. And the previous, I think you have completed and done your homework also. So now let us solve one by one all the questions. And listen very carefully and try to understand. So now here, the length, in question number 9, it is given the length of a line segment AB. So, number 9, okay? The length of line segment AB is equal to how much? Let us see. AB is 2 by 3 of the length of the line segment CD. Okay. So, length of the line segment CD. So, 2 by 3 of CD. Okay. 2 by 3 of CD. Now, what it is saying? The length of another line segment EF is 3 by 8 of the length of the line segment AB. Now, length of EF. So, we don't know CD. Okay. We don't know the length of CD. So, we can write here instead of a CD, we can write for this put value of CD. Okay. Value of CD is equal to X. Understood? Now, we can write here 2 by 3 X. Okay. So, length of AB is equal to 2 by 3 X. From where x has come? Because we have put the value of CD as x now. So, x has come like that. Now, what it is given? That the length of another line EF. So, EF is how much? Is 3 by 8. Write the numbers properly. Okay. 3 by 8 of the length of the line segment AB. So, length of the line segment AB is how much we have got? We have got 2 by 3. So, it is saying that EF, 2 by 3 X it is. Okay. Now, it is saying that EF is 3 by 8 of AB. Okay. Let us see. 3 by 8 of AB. AB is how much? 2 by 3 X. So, we will write 3 by 8 into 2 by 3 of x. Okay. 2 by 3 of x. Now let us solve this first. Okay. So when we solve this, what do you see? 3 and 3. Cross multiplication. They cut each other. 1 and 1. 3 ones of 3. 3 ones are 3. They cut by 3. Now 2 and 8. Okay. 2 and 8. They can cut. Cut with what? With 2. 2 ones are 2. 2 fours are 8. Now, how much we have got the value? See, EF is equal to how much? 1 and 1, they will multiply 1 by 1. 1 and 1 is 1 and 4 into 1. Okay, 4 into 1, 4. So, EF is equal to 1 by 4 X. So, EF is equal to X value. We know that X is CD. So, you can write here 1 by 4 of CD. So, EF is what? EF is 1 by 4 of CD. So, question is asking you that what fraction of the length of CD is equal to the length of EF? So, fraction, what fraction of CD? 1 by 4 of CD is equal to EF. Okay, 1 by 4 of CD is equal to EF. Now, then if CD, now the value of CD is given to you. If CD is 4 centimeter, okay, value of CD is 4 centimeter, then what is the value of F? So, EF is equal to 1 by 4. Now, we will put the value of CD, okay? How much? 4. What do we see? That this 4 and this 4, they will cut each other 1 to 1. That is 1 by 1 is equal to 1. Okay, 1 by 1 is equal to 1. So EF is how much? EF is 1 centimeter. Now you can see 4 is CD is 4 centimeter, 1 by 4 is 1. Okay, that is if you divide 4 by 4, it will be 1 only. So EF is equal to 1 centimeter. Now let us solve number 10. So we will do number 10. In number 10, what do we see? There are 800 students in a school. So number of students, total number of, we'll write word problem like this. Total number of students, okay, in a school. How many? 800. Okay. Now it is saying that if 1 by 10 of the students were absent. So number of students absent we will find. Number of students absent is equal to how much? Is equal to 1 by 10 of number of students in a school. So how many? 800. Okay. So how many are absent? Let us see. This 0 and 10. So that is 800 divided by 1 into 800. If you will do, then how much you will get? 800 divided by 10. Okay. 800 divided by 10. This 0 and 0, they will cancel. So how many students are absent? 80 students are absent. Okay, number of students absent? 80. Now, number of students present. So how we will find out the number of students present? When we will have total number of students minus number of students absent is how much? 80. Total number of students? 800. Students absent? 80. So how much we will get? Students present? 720. So how many students are present that day? 720 students are present. Now what it is saying? Also find the fraction of a students of the school that was present that day. So fraction of students present that day, how much? 720 is the number of students present divided by total number of students. So total number of students is 800. Now cut this. 0, 0 will cancel. Now 72 and 80. With what we can cut? Directly we can cut from 8. Okay, we know that 72 comes in the table of 8. 80 also comes in the table of 8. But slowly we will go follow the steps first. Let us cut this with 2. Because you see that at last both have even numbers. So we will see that 36 times 72 will be divided by 2. And 40 times this. Now again let us cut this. Okay. So 18 by 20. And children, if you know directly to cut, okay, if you know directly to cut, you know that in which table they are coming, and the numbers should come in the numbers, they should cut from the same number. You have to cut from the same number. Now again 18 by 20, they are cut by 2, 9 by 10. Okay, that is 9 by 10. So fraction of students present is 9 by 10. Now this is your question. This was your question number 10. We have done 10 number. Now we will do number 12. So I think you are understanding. If you don't understand, see the video again. Okay, see the video again and step by step, children, try to follow it. And if you don't understand, ask in class. Okay, don't worry, ask in class. So now, then number 12, we will solve number 12, 11 we have done in the previous class. So number 12 is, a man has 2 bundles of notes. The total money in the first bundle is 480. So amount in the first bundle, 2 bundle he is having notes. Okay, let us see amount of money in the first bundle, how much it is. Money in first bundle, how much is equal to
rupees 480.
Okay.
Now, amount of money in the second bundle is 300.
So, amount in the second bundle, how much it is? Rupees 300. Okay,
rupees 300.
This is 3 written.
Now he gives 1/4 of the first bundle and 1/3 of the other bundle to Bunty.
Now there is Bunty who is getting the money, so we will write amount given to Bunty. Let us see how much Bunty gets. Is equal to
how much it is?
1/4. Okay, 1/4 of the first bundle, 1/4 of 480, plus he gets more, 1/3 of the second bundle also. Now how much is getting?
Now see, directly we can cut it by 4. Okay, we can cut it by 4, but let us solve again with 2.
2, now this will be, divide and see children, you will get 240. Again cut this with 2. You see, both are even numbers now, so they can be cut by 2. So 2 ones are 2, 120. Try to solve it yourself. Now 1/3 into 300, now cut this. You will find this is 100. Now just add 120 plus 100, rupees 220.
Now see, Bunty is getting rupees 220. Now there is one more person who is getting the amount. So he gives 1/3 of the first bundle and 1/5 of the other bundle to Bunny. Who is this? Binny.
Okay. So amount, let us see how much Binny is getting. Amount given to Binny, how much? 1/3 of first plus 1/5 of second. He is also getting from first and second both. Now divide and see. 480 from 3. Okay, you will find that you will get 160. Divide and see. And see whether I am doing correct or not. You do yourself. Now 300 divided by 5. Get 60. Now when you add 160 plus 60. Get 220. This also see whether the amount is coming to 20 or not. Now what do you see? In this it is saying who received more. So I am seeing here that Bunty also gets 220. Binny also gets 220. That means no one receives more. Both are getting equal amount. And by how much? If they are not getting equal, if they are getting equal amount, that means no one gets more. Okay? And the amount will be nil. That means amount more will be nil. Okay? Now, number 14. Question number 15. 14 we have done. Now 15. Done in the previous class, not now. So number 15. See. The distance between two stations is 25 kilometer. So you write here distance. Write in good handwriting, okay? Your handwriting might be better than me, so write nicely. Between two stations is equal to how much? 25 kilometer, okay?
Now, a train starts from one station and goes 15 kilometer towards the other station.
Now when a train is there, It goes only 15 kilometers. It's not going, it is not covering the whole distance. So distance covered by the train. Distance covered by train going only 15 kilometers. Not going to the, from one station to the other station. In between it is there. It stops at 15 kilometers. Okay. So distance covered by train is equal to 15 kilometers. Now, what fraction of distance between the two stations remains to be covered? Now, what fraction is remaining to be covered? So, fraction. First, let us see distance remaining to be covered. Okay. Distance to be covered. Okay. Right here. To be covered. It is equal to how much? When you see, 25 kilometer was the distance between the two station, but the train covers only 15 kilometer. Now how much is left? 25 minus 15, 10 kilometer. Okay, this is the distance to be covered. Now it is saying that what fraction of the distance remains to be covered. So fraction, in fraction how we will find out? In fraction we will find out the distance remaining to be covered divided by the total distance, like this. Okay, divided by the total distance. Now what we see, 10 and 25, they cut by 5, 2 times, and this 5 times. So fraction is equal to 2 by 5. So it's easy, you can do. Watch very nicely, okay? If you have problem, again see, try to understand each and everything. Again, if you don't understand, okay, then ask. Now, a train travels 45, 1 by 3 every hour. Every hour for the first 3.5 hours after leaving a station. Try to understand the question first. So, there is a train, okay? So, a train, how much it is traveling? 45. So, distance covered by train. Let us write that and solve. Distance covered by train is equal to 45, 1 by 3 kilometer. Okay. For 3.5 hours. So for the first 3 covered by train 44 kilometer, it covers in 1 hour. Okay, it covers in 1 hour. This is in 1 hour. Now it is saying that it goes for 3.5 hours. So for 3.5 hours, how we will write? Distance covered in 3.5 hours. Distance in 3.5 hour is equal to how much? In 1 hour it is this much. So in 3.5 hours how much? We will multiply 45, 1 by 3 into 3, 1 by 2. Okay. Into 3, 1 by 2. Now let us convert this into improper fraction. So when you multiply 45 into 3, okay, 45 into 3, what you will find? That you will get 135. Multiply and see. Now add 1 to this. This will be 136. You know that denominator you have to write here? Into 3, 1 by 2. Into how much? 3 2's are 6 plus 1. 7 by 2. Now can this number, they cut each other? Let us see. Now we see 6 at last, 2 here. That means they are even number. So they can be cut by 2. And 2 ones are 2. Cut this by 2. What do you see? 6 times and then 168. Solve and see. Cut, divide 136 by 2. You will find it is 68 divided by 3 into 7. Now what we have to do? Now multiply 68 and 7. Now you cannot cut. Now it is multiplication time. So 68 into 7.
So how much you will get? Let us see. 68 multiplied by 7. 8 7 ja 56, right? 5 over here. Oh, sorry. 5 over here. Then 7 6 are 42. 42 plus 5, 47. So that is 476. And 3 will be written like this. Okay? This is in 3 and half hours. 476. Now, after that, now it has not stopped. It is covering more distance. After that, it travels 50. Now, distance covered in how many hours? For the next 2.5 hours, distance covered in next, you write next 2.5 hours. Okay, how much? Is equal to 51 by 2. Okay, so 51 by 2, let us solve. In 51 by 2, and then see, this is in the next. So here what we will do, 51 by 2 in 2.5 hours. We will take this 2.5 hours also, because this is the distance covered in the next 2.5 hours, and it goes for, in 1 hour it covers 50 and half, and for then it will cover 2.5. In 2.5 hours it is going to cover more. How much? We'll multiply that and see. Now you will get 101 divided by 2 into how much? 5 by 2. Okay, into 5 by 2. Now any number does not cut, so directly multiply. 101 into 5, that is 505, divided by how much? The denominators, they also will multiply. So 2 into 2, 4. Okay, 505 by 4. Now it is saying that what distance does the train travel during the 6 hours? So during the 6 hours, from where it has come? 3.5 plus 2.5. When you add, you will get 6 hours. So in 1 hour, it has, in 3.5 hours, it has. So now in 3.5 hours, it has covered 476 by 3. And 2.5 hours, it has gone 505 by 4. So distance covered in 6 hours, here in 6 hours is equal to 476 divided by 3 plus 505 divided by 4. Now you know how to solve. From now, take out the LCM. LCM will be of a 3 and 4, the LCM will be 12. Okay, this is your unlike fraction. Okay, multiplication of unlike fraction and then addition. You know that first you have to take out the LCM. We have taken LCM as 12. Now how many times this 12 comes in the table of 4? In 3 times. So what you have to do, this 476 you will multiply with 3. Okay, 476 multiply with 3 plus 505 multiply with how much? 4 threes are 12. Okay, so here see here, in this 476 multiply with 4. 476 multiply with 4. Why? 3 4s are 12. Okay, 3 4s are 12. So multiply this with 4 and this you multiply with 3. Okay, addition of the mixed fraction we are going to do now. Okay, of the unlike fraction we have. See, now what do you get?
So when we multiply over here, now here when we have taken the LCM as 12, what we have seen that this 12 comes in the table of 3 how many times? 4 times. Now what you will do? This numerator you will multiply with 4 plus 505. Okay, 505. Why we are multiplying with 3? Because this 12 comes in the table of 4 how many times? 3 times. So multiply this with 3. 505, the numerator with 3. Now what we have to do? We will add. Okay, we will add first. Multiply this 476 into 4. So let us see. 476 into 4. 6 fours are 24. 2 times. 7 fours are 28. 0. 3 times. 16. 9 times. So 1904 plus 505 into 3. So that is, let us see this also. 505 divided by 3. 15 and 15. Solvency you will get 1515. 15 and 15 divided by how much? Divided by 12. Now just add this. When we add, we get 915 plus 9, 4. Okay, that is 14. 4 we will write, 1 we will carry, 1 plus 1, 2, and then plus 1, 3. So 3419 divided by 12 we will get like this. Okay, 3419 divided by 12. Now let us solve this. 3419 divided by 12. So we know this is 2 times 24. Write 2 over here. Now subtract 0 and 1. Now bring this 1 down. Yeah. Now how many times? 12 8s are. Okay, 96. 12 8s are 96. 8 times. Now bring this down. Subtract and find. You will get 59. Okay, 59. Now what we have to do? We will see 59 and 12. How many times? 4 times. 48. Now this is 4 times. Remainder is 11. So how we will write this in fraction? We will write it 284. Okay, whole. Then 11 remainder over here and 12 downside. So 284 into 284 whole 11 by 12. Okay, we are going to write like this. We will get as the mixed fraction. So this is that you have to do in. Now next question number 18. So children, question number 18, you have to solve it yourself. Okay, it is easy. You have to solve it yourself. I am giving you the hint because each and every question I have solved, and I want that number 18 you solve yourself, and if you are not able to solve, then you ask. Now let me explain you what you have to do there. Okay, first question, let us discuss. A large vessel is full of oil. So there is a large vessel which has oil in it. A smaller vessel can contain 2 by 25 of the amount of oil contained in the larger vessel. So 2 by 25 of the larger vessel. So suppose we don't know how much the larger vessel contains. So we will write over there, larger vessel contains X amount and the smaller vessel it contains 2 by 25 of the larger vessel, that is 2 by 25 of X. Okay, that is the capacity of the smaller vessel. Now since, now see here, oil is taken out from the larger vessel 10 times by filling the smaller vessel. So since by filling the smaller vessel 10 times, the oil from the larger vessel was taken out. Okay, so what we have seen, that 10 times
The oil has been taken out from the larger vessel by the smaller vessel. Now, what we will write then? Therefore, the fraction of the oil taken out from the larger vessel, how much it will be? 10 into, okay? 10 into how much? 2 by 5 of x. Why? Because 10 times of the larger vessel, okay? So, 10 into 2 by 5 x. So, what you will find? That it is 4, okay? And the 2 by 25. So, 4 by 5x, okay? This is 4 by 5x. And what this is? The fraction of oil taken out from the large vessel is 4 by 5x. Now, the fraction of oil left, okay? The fraction of oil left, how much it will be? The fraction of oil was x. So, how much will be left? If you have taken out this much, then minus 4 by 5x, okay? The fraction will be x minus how much it has been taken? This 4 by 5x. So, 4 by 5x, that is, you know to take out the LCM. LCM of this will be 5. Now, suppose here it is 1, okay? We know that it is 1 over here. So, this will become 5x minus 4x is equal to how much? X by 5. Okay? This will be x by 5. Now, how much it is? Now, question is asking, what fraction of oil is left in the larger vessel? So, how much is left in the larger vessel? It was x. So, it is x by 5 left in the larger vessel is 1 by 5 times. So, fraction in the left in the smaller vessel is 1 by 5. So, this like this you have to do. Okay, thank you everyone and try to solve it. If you don't understand, again I am telling you, try to do each and every question properly. And if you have face any problem, if you face any problem, then you ask. Bye. Have a good day.